There's one word that gorgeous women rarely hear, probably because it's pretty counterintuitive, but it can actually boost attraction, get a girl to start chasing you, and make her see you as a real man. Now, that one word and the concept that I'm about to share with you can set you apart from all other guys and get her to see you as the prize. My name is Matt Artisan from The Attractive Man, and this is one word that will make women chase you.
I'm Matt. Has mastered the art of seduction.
Many boot camps encourage men to be assertive.
The woman wants to be turned on.
We've done all the testing, we know what works.
Now, what I'm about to share with you is slightly controversial. I know that some of you guys watching this video probably won't agree with what I'm about to say. But first, let me share a quick story. I was in Belgrade, Serbia about 5 years ago, about to teach a boot camp, and I see this gorgeous, supermodel looking goddess walking down the street. And naturally, I run up to her and I approach her. By the way, you can see exactly how to do that in other videos here on the channel. And everything was going great. You know, she was into the approach, but she told me she's in a hurry. She said she has to go.
I have to go.
No, what you have to do is tell me one cool thing about you, then you can go. Now, I know that kind of seems like a dick thing to say. You know, girl's in a hurry and I tell her no, she can't go yet. But her eyes lit up, partly in shock. She couldn't believe I said that, but I saw, like, you know, that sparkle in her eyes. Like, I could tell she was more attracted to me, probably because she had never heard anything like that before. The truth is that the hottest women are used to men throwing themselves at them, and they're used to getting everything handed freely to them. Right? They don't have to work for anything. They get everything for free. For example, when I lived in Las Vegas, I dated a really attractive cocktail waitress, and she would get into the hottest clubs for free, get bottle service for free, like $10,000 tables. She would get really expensive meals paid for her. She would even get invited to expensive vacations just because she was hot. You see, when women get everything they want at no cost, then they start to expect it. And pretty soon they don't value it as much. Doesn't mean they necessarily don't appreciate it, it just means they don't value the men who give them everything freely without them having to earn it just because they're hot. On top of that, beautiful women almost never have to work for a man being attracted to her, right? Men just flock to her because she's so damn good looking, and she never has to do anything to, like, earn his interest. These women are used to guys showing way too much interest too soon and putting them on a pedestal. So if you want to attract these kinds of women who are used to guys just fawning all over them because they're so damn hot, then you have to do the exact opposite. Stop putting women on a pedestal. Now, before I forget, make sure to subscribe to this channel. If you're not already subscribed, do it right now and hit that bell icon so we can notify you about upcoming videos. So you've probably already guessed what that one word is, you know, that will set you apart from all those supplicating guys who will do anything she wants and hopes for a small piece of her pie. It's the word no. No?
No.
No.
That's right. Just saying the word no to a beautiful woman who's used to getting everything handed to her on a silver platter is very intriguing. You see, men that don't stick to their guns and sacrifice their own needs, wants, passions, desires, get walked over by women and are not respected. For example, let's say your mission at this point of your life is to write a novel. So every night you go down to your basement to have some peace and quiet to work on your novel. But your wife constantly keeps pulling you from it. She's asking for help with the dishes or clean the house or just to spend some time with her or even to have sex with her, and it's kind of hard to say no to that one. But if you keep on putting your novel aside just to please your woman, and eventually you just give up on it and you realize, oh, I just need to focus on her and I'm gonna please her and I'm gonna make her my passion, my mission, she will not only lose respect for you, but her attraction for you will die. What's really important is that you don't put a woman before your mission or purpose in life. David Deida said in his book, Way of the Superior Man, if a man prioritizes his relationship over his highest purpose, he weakens himself, disserves the universe, and cheats his woman of an authentic man who can offer his full, undivided presence. Even if she says that she wants to be number one in your life, What she really wants is to support a man in his mission and purpose. She doesn't want a man who throws it all away just for her. Once in a while, she might even test you to see if she can knock you off your course. A good woman will do this. Now, she doesn't want to actually knock you off your course. She just wants to feel that you are a real man that can stand up to her and say no to her. Now, of course, she's probably gonna be a little displeased that she didn't get what she wanted, but she'll be more attracted to you in the long run. Now, this doesn't mean that you should say no to everything she wants or use it as some sort of manipulation tactic. Just like in the novel example, you might say yes to her sometimes. It's all about balance. You should say no when you really mean it. And that can apply at any point in the interaction. Like with the girl in Serbia, I said it within a minute of meeting her. Now, that's not gonna work all the time. If the girl wasn't attracted to me, she probably would have just laughed and walked away. But the point is to be more of a challenge with women so that they see you as a real man instead of a supplicating, needy little child. And this isn't meant to be like a harsh thing. You don't actually have to say the word no all the time. No, 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 no. You can just make fun little restrictions every time you also make a request. I call this technique restricted requests.
Let's go back to my place, but no sex. Let's go get coffee, but only for 10 minutes, then I have to go. No touching below the belt. Here, put your number in here, but no calling 20 times a day. That's all you get. No more.
Now, obviously these are just little one-liner examples, but women usually love them because they leave them wanting more. When you put a restriction on something, it shows her that you're not that easy, like, you know, every other guy that she's used to. Because it's no fun for a woman if she knows without a shadow of a doubt that you're 100% into her and that you'll pretty much do anything for her. She actually wants to wonder a little, and she wants to even have to win you over. This is actually the basis of flirting. Flirting is not just showing your interest all the time. It's showing your interest, but then playfully taking it away. It keeps her guessing a little bit, which makes things a lot more interesting for her. Women love to text and call their girlfriends and say, "Oh, he did this thing. It was so sweet. He really showed that he was into me. But then he did this other thing, and I'm not really sure if he's into me. What do you think about that?" And they, you know, call all their girlfriends getting opinions. Women love doing that. If she knows right away that you're totally in love with her, you would go home with her, you'd even make her your girlfriend, then the game is over for her. The fun for her is in the flirting. So if you're the type of guy that never says no to women and you're not used to using restrictions, then start doing it. You'll notice that her eyes light up as she realizes that you're different than all the other guys out there, and she begins flirting back with you. Now, if you really want to know how to be a challenge, I created a YouTube video that's all about qualification, which is one of the best concepts, principles, tactics, whatever you want to call it, when it comes to being a challenge. You should be doing this in all of your interactions, throughout the interaction, because it's one of the best ways to get her to see you as the prize and get her to start chasing you within minutes, sometimes even seconds of meeting. So check that out right now. There's a link to the right of the screen. Click that and watch that video, and make sure to subscribe to this channel. If you're not already subscribed, hit that subscribe button. And if you want us to coach you live in person, then check out our bootcamp schedule and schedule a free consultation with us. My name is Matt Artisan from The Attractive Man, and I'll see you in the next video.